Namaste. Just in time to say good morning to you. One more minute is there. So, so it's a great pleasure to be here. But I was yesterday, was talking to Dr. Das and also Honorable Vice Chancellor today with our persons from MSME, distinguished person in the audience, and there I recognize quite a few people. I had written it before. I am glad, which I will mention it when I am talking. First of all, I should thank Dr. Chandrasekhar Nautiyal, the Vice Chancellor, and Dr. Das and the other organizers who had given me an opportunity to share this, because they told, come. I was worried from Bombay to Bangalore to Dehradun. In those days, linkages were very, very poor. Air linkages, they said it is available thanks to Indigo. Anyway, it was all done. I am here. So my memories goes back. Dehradun is not today for me. I had come here 1974 or 75, I think. That was in connection with doing our Indian satellites. Even though we were not at launch ready, we were going to do the Aryabhat. Even at that time, we had planned about the defense things also. We used to study in those days Himalayan range propagation unit, as in Dr. Bhagirtha was there, we had done. So from those time onwards, it is there. And one of the distinguished person from here, he was also a part of ISRO in those days. Neelambar Pandey, he just passed away. Would have been 90 plus. He used to always say in those days, 1970s and all, North India, South India and all that, you know, the Tamil Nadu politics and all were in that. So he used to say, Rajan, ye kya hai? Ye log kyun North Indian, South Indian kyun bolte hain? Main to Almora mein janam liya tha. Mera to sab, pura Bharat ka sab. 90% of India is for me, South Indians. You were born very close to Kanyakumari, so 90% of the Indians are North Indians. He used to tell them, very nice person. So it's not only that. Now I'll fast forward. There are so many things which we have done here. Well, let me first is the great nostalgia because of the Vision 4040. Forget all those other things, 74. Enjoyable dating back to 1998 when the then Union S&T Minister of Dr. Murali Manohar Joshi desired us, TIFAC, to create. He talked about the Vision 2020 for the other one, to create one for Uttarakhand. In those days, yet to be born Uttaranchal. They were all talking it as Uttaranchal. So we did that. Then it is based on that book, etc. So, but quite a few things was done locally also. So when we started, TIFAC's philosophy was not good enough to make documents. Your documents has to be seen whether you are doing it on the ground, a little bit. Sample, because they are all done in such a way. Actually, the earlier speaker, he had mentioned about it. No use making a lot of documents. They should be implementable. If something is not implementable, it is not vision. It is only a slogan. So it is with that in view, we did. And we did it for Uttaranchal also. And that brings me quite a few things. It is all here. You know, the projects of Uttaranchal agricultural project. You know, who was the person who was leading it from here? There are many here, Pinder Valley, so many things. I am not going to spend time. That gentleman, Professor A.N. Purohit. I have written it here. I was going to mention, I didn't know whether he was going to come because I didn't have the full program. When I saw it in the morning, he is there, he came here. So he was doing it and he was linked with another great person who is no more. But in addition, sir, I am very happy, God bless you. From those days to now, you look much younger. You look 10 years younger. That is immediately a good place. So I had extra blood that how much old he will be, etc. The phase was cycling. Then your vice chancellor in those days on the whole of the country, some very advanced viruses, antiviral plant protection, he was working with S.K. Sinha. He was a young man then. Even though he's a young man, he's a lot of energy there. So there are so many which were done. So I'm not going to tell all of them. It'll be so much because they have done it in health sector. So many areas were done. I learned from the late Bachi Singh Rawat, which I have to tell. Because somebody who will tell plainly about how the troubles of the Uttaranchal, Uttarakhand, now the upper part of the Uttaranchal, that is the hills. So he used to tell, you know, we had quite a big team. Then he will tell me, he was also a junior minister. So when we were implementing, Rajan Saab, इधर तो सब बाहर के लोग आके एक हफ्ता दो हफ्ता रहते हैं देवभूमि करके बोल के चले जाते हैं. इधर जो रहते हैं ना उनको तो ये नरक है. सो ही यूज्ड टू टेल हाउ मच द कम्युनिकेशन प्रॉब्लम्स वर, हाउ इवन इफ दे डू सम प्लेंटी दे कांट ट्रांसपोर्ट इट. यू हैड गिवन ऑल दैट. वी वर ट्राइंग टू डू सम प्रोजेक्ट्स ऑन दैट. सो आई विल नॉट गेट इनटू दिस. माय जॉब वाज नॉट दैट. नाउ माय इंटर्न इन टेलिंग अबाउट इट इज दैट आई लर्न टू थिंग्स देन important macro item. Uttaranchal, even now it is so, Uttarakhand was a part money order economy. That is the sons of these places predominantly go out, earn money and remit. By itself it's not bad, but it causes some problems. You can't have everything internally. Big country, great countries, people have gone out. But that is one side of the story. The other side of the story, which many of you don't think, that is why we were able to do so many projects, is that this has got a very high achieving, what I call as a diaspora. They belong here, they go, they are in security services, they are doctors, they are so many things, including our vice chancellor, Din. He is a Uttarakhand man. He went and worked somewhere else, all over India, nothing wrong. So many good doctors, we got generals, all of them. Now, that gave us a confidence of doing many things here. How do you link? They win, they are best all over India, by any Indian standard you put, by any foreign, world standard you put. Now, I see, this is, they are the great strengths. I consider this one of the great strengths of Uttarakhand. You are 2040 now, you are going to go now. They are required. You don't have to bring them back every time. It should not be. But how do you tap them? The network which they have will be the one which will link you to the world. Don't look at it a small state. You have to look at it globally. So this is the how to rope them in. The same within Uttarakhand. We did some of it in our own TIFAC projects and it was very successful. Mobile hospital, etc. I was told. This is the strength number one. For Uttarakhand, it will remain. Two, some of them can come back also, no problem. Second is the fact that after the formation in 9th November 2000, I know the statistics of those days, I don't want to bore you with that. From that to now, in approximately 20 years, it has grown very well. It is better than all India average. Because we also, especially young people, you have to be impatient. I am impatient even at my age. You have to be impatient to do something. Because the Saab told 10-15 years, mujhe nahi chalega. 3-4 saal mein change hona chahiye because world is changing so fast. So, it is not definitely, take any indicator, it is not in the bottom of the list at all. In fact, it is the 6th richest state per capita wise. Don't go by GDP wise, you are a small state. You can't compare it with Maharashtra and other thing for the size. You have to see the number of people, how the income is. So what it shows, item number one, the diaspora strength. Item number two, there is something within the people and whatever good, bad, indifferent of the powers that be, the ministers, the politicians to bureaucrats and all that, there is something seems to be they want to grow. They are able to grow. Better island to average. Now, having said this, when you are now to look ahead the next 20 years, after a good record of close to 20 years, what do you aim at? This is what you have to think. Many of you are young now. You will be around reaching 40s. No, you will be just crossed 40s. You are going to be bearing the burden. Because 40 itself will be taking a lot of responsibility. You may not be necessarily a vice chancellor or a big businessman or a CEO, etc. But you will be doing so much on which organizations will depend. Things will depend. Some of you may become big business persons. Many things are possible. So But what do you aim at? Challenges now or many more? You can't ride on the same thing, because that growth was due to many low-hanging fruits. You understand the low-hanging fruits? Jaldi-jaldi pluck karte hain. Upar ka jana hai toh, it's going to be tough, but they are more sweeter. In a world when where the global linkages to economy, business, agriculture and technologies are very strong, one cannot afford to think in the world mode. 20 years ahead is too long in one sense. The rapid changes taking place all over India and the aspirations. Many of you have got very different aspirations than what we saw, the people around in the 2090s, etc. Many of you want it used to be so. And the young people will ask more. So, you want more goodies. You want a better living. And then the day-to-day living in 20 years, many you prepare for from now to 2040. Most likely at 2040, I won't be here. Okay? Because this will be some short of some 94, 90 plus crossing forever. It will be very tough. But I'm telling you, you will have 2 to 3 changes, major paradigmic changes in economics and studies and everything, way of living, way you work. You have to be ready to change. Ja gaya, 23 mein job mil gaya, then I want to retire at 60. Can it be extended to 62? No way. It's going to be a very different world. It is already taking place. So that is what it is. But it is not difficult, I tell you. So it is against this background and context, we need to look at the years ahead. That's what I am going to tell you. I have seen 4 themes, especially emphasized, those tourism, women empowerment, etc., etc. They are good. But I would touch upon this in a slightly more different way, because many of them are interlinked nowadays. Because many where we thought we have done work, which we have never thought of gender equality, they are the one turned out to be, which was many more, the Punjab milk project, etc. I won't be able to tell all that full stories here, because Mrs. Poonawalla was leading that. So it is very different. Now kindly pardon me, because there are a lot of challenges, and challenges in implementation, conceptualization and implementation. Because older thinking will say, nahi, 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 ye nahi chalega, hum toh nahi kar sakte hain. Because they don't want to be very ambitious. Some will say, pura muni chahiye mujhe. So kindly pardon me if I adopt one mode of delivery. You would have known. Satyam bruyat, priyam bruyat. I think all of you know the meaning, no? Satyam bruyat, priyam bruyat. Then the third everybody will say, I reject it. Na bruyat, satyam apriyam. Why? In this country, using that, we have started doing bruyat, asatyam, priyam. This is the problem. You understood, no? You are finding it difficult? Okay. Satyam bruyat, tell truth. Priyam bruyat, tell it nicely, pleasant things. Then the third one is, na bruya satyam apriyam. Don't tell truths which are not nice, which are not pleasant. Because this was done in those good old days, when the king may probably cut your head. Or some powerful fellow may cut your head. So therefore what we have started doing, especially post-independence, it is too much. Take it from you, I was in 64, I was 20. I joined space program with Vikram Sarabhai. I have seen the world. What we have started doing, bruyat, asatyam priyam, tell untruths which are very pleasant. Okay? This was, now it is not my discovery, a great man of this country, Tulsidas, has noticed that this is a problem. Because it has existed then, I think, in those days also. So, what he says, mantri, this, if you want me to translate this, it will be a little this thing because you have to know your language. Even though it is a little one, but anyway, I will tell you. Mantri, guru or vaidya, piya bolahi, baya as. Raja, dharma or than, teenahi begahi nas. You understand? No. I say, Hindi literature is so beautiful. I could have spoken this whole thing in Hindi. I have spoken convocation in Hindi. even though it is not my language. I didn't study in a proper way. Anyway, I will tell you, Mantri means minister, advisor, whichever it is. It is taken as an advisor. Guru means a person who tells about good things, bad things, etc., etc. Aru, our Vaidya, the doctor. Piya Bolahi, by us. They tell very nice things because of two things. Bhaya, nahi to aas. Arre kuch achha, Raja sahab bahut achha kar diye, to thoda aur ek thoda gold medal de denge. Ab ye pet mein kuch nahi hai. Sab theek hai. Bahut achha ho gaya, to bahut aur ek de denge. So, bhaya aas. If he tells, then what is the result? Is Raja, Mantri aisa kiya, to Raja. Guru aisa kiya, to dharam. The order, everything. Or thun, body. If your vaidya keeps on telling everything is nice with you, body. Teenahi, begahi nas. He has not even told nas, begahi nas. It will go away. So, I am going to adopt Tulsidas. Okay, pardon me. Sometimes I will be a little stiff on something. Now, while all the theme, etc., etc., I am sure that they will be generating more. That doesn't seem to be one which says creation of wealth. Economic development is very crucial. Dharma, artha, kama. We all desire kama. We all want to enjoy. We won't tell it openly. And we also emphasize dharma in public life. Everywhere people say dharma. What is the glue between the two? Is artha. You want to do something good to somebody, you need money. Otherwise your compassion is no use. So, we need to do economic growth. Economic growth means incomes to people. I am not considering jobs or this, that and all. Income at the level, that means what is it? It comes state as a whole. State as you are approximately 1 crore. By 2040, you will be 1.2. You can't, whatever you try, it will become 1.2. Maybe 1.18, maybe. So it is going to be that. So, in the next 20 years. Now wealth, you had to generate wealth for all this, much more. And the trouble with enjoyment is that whatever you enjoy, at that level if you keep it for 10 years, you will get bored. This is called, in economics it will be called hedonism. Hedonistic saturation will come, which is truth. So you can't just say, "Ye karo." Some few people can go into the hills and they can become sannyasis and yogis, but most of us will not. So that is what we need to do. Now let us look at it. How do we generate? Already Das Saab has indicated some item. Tertiary sector means services sector. Is that gives 39.76 growth rate, means GDP, the pie in the GDP. Growth rate is 13.56. That's the fastest. Secondary sector, manufacturing, 49.74. Growth rate is 9.71%. Now, this is all in terms of value addition, in terms of money, not in terms of production, mind you. Sometimes I produce 1 lakh worth product, 10. Then I have done so much. But 1 rupee worth, I have done 50,000, it is lower. But 50,000 also will be required. So, primary sector, that is basically agriculture, little bit of quarrying, etc., 10.50, and growth rate is 5.4. These are all available in quite a few things. This also I will try to leave it there. Value addition is what is the key. What is value addition? I will tell you in simple terms. Because economists, good economists are here. So they will tell you in a way which will be very correct, but it will become very difficult. Ordinary potato you take. I say, bej do udar se, khet se bej do. It will fetch you very low money. You clean it up and then do it and then take good ones and bad ones, that fellow will give more money. Usko thoda kaat ke, chips bana ke, so open bhejo, slightly more money. You pack it up in a normal plastic, you get one. Then you get into, what is that other one, lay chips. All little technologies. You know that by the time it goes to the Haldiram or those type of chips, same 1 kilo will fetch you something like 200 to 300 rupees. Of course, there are other things in between involved, But this is value addition. The same with the teachers also. Your textbook is only 50 rupees, 100 rupees. Your teacher ka kitna feel dete hum. Because the university has run it. So there are all the in-between value additions. So that is what every money added in the work, a little bit, that's enough. You don't have to do the whole thing. So your primary important job in this 2040 is how to see the primary sector. Now, you can't increase it more than 10 or 15%. It's not possible all around the world. It will probably remain at 10. But how do you create more money in it? You are lucky in Uttarakhand because only 30%, just seeing how many people are only 33% in workforce here. All India is 52. That is why the farmer problems. You cannot go and dig that 1 acre of land again and again and again. There are limitations of science, how much it can give. So you have to increase value addition. That means don't worry only about grain and the traditional one. You have to go for a very upper end ones, agriculture. Same thing, gives more money. You grow asparagus, it will give more money. So here I just saw what is happening here. Very interestingly, I just looked at it. So you have to make this. I will tell that example. How do you do? So it does not matter if the number of persons in agriculture go down. In fact, you have to take them on to these MSMEs and other things, even including the women workforce. You have to take into that. One key issue for the Vision 20, the immediate and the short term, is to improve the productivity. Productivity means not to get more grains, to get some other product which will give you more money. Okay? It cannot be done by just trying to do it again, etc. High-end agriculture is the first one, not by food alone, because you can get food from elsewhere. The wide range of climatic conditions, even in a small geographic area, that is the strength of Uttarakhand. You got from the heat to the highest one, going very close to the upper trend. I came across a report and I was very happy then. I think it is true, very good. Vice Chancellor told me, yes, he knows the thing, which is always I get worried when I read something, is it confirmed? The JV by the floriculture chaffy, JV between a Dutch government and Uttarakhand government. Chrysanthemum, tulips, zaids, etc. They make the bulbs. And then I think Bimtal, they got the machine which will make it, so that they want to give the seeds, because everywhere, even in Bangalore, people like to have a chrysanthemum there, pots, etc., etc. Seeds are importing. So they have done 2 million. My question is, why not ramp up such items on a large scale, supply for the whole large part of India? It can become a hub. Even export to a number of things which are possible. And then in addition, Uttarakhand has got 130 or special species of herbs. They can be commercial, but it has to be done with a lot of scientific input, not just to go and pluck and then do it, it'll be gone. They will become endangered. With the world and India everywhere turning to herbal, I recently read a report about commodities. Very surprising thing. About 5 years or 6 years ago, if you are gone, you get a Colgate toothpaste. It will be, they will try this one, they will put this white, because I have grown up the Sibaka time onwards, all this only. But now, you get into Colgate, Vedashakti, Hindustan, everybody is running around, and 77% of the commodities, soap, oil, everybody, including the MNCs, the foreign companies, are all getting into something herbal. Aloe vera, aya, ye aya, o aya, neem aya, so many things which you even don't know the names are coming in. So that is the demand. Whether it is good, bad, indifferent, I don't know. They may not be bad, because bad people will reject. So this is a great strength, a great opportunity for high value added one. I will not put more of these things in it. In addition, some farms, newer techniques are possible. See, your Patanjali Ramdev coming up here is an example of it. But there can be, even he has only tapped a 1/5 or 1/10 of the market. There are so many things possible, provided it is done scientifically. And everything need not be done here. You can get it from somewhere, put it, etc., etc. So the market size is large. In addition, some of the farms, newer techniques of fertigation, hydroponics, aeroponics, protected plant cultivation, many of these things are possible. You have a vice chancellor here who lived all his life in plants. Then Prohit Saab is there. They all know how the plants will behave, how you will do. How do you commercialize? When you commercialize, you have to be careful. It is not just ramping up on other things. That is why a lot of value added, how will you do? Again, these items of agriculture cannot be seen as standalone. Now I will come to, don't think that only that. They have to be marketed. They have to be seen localized. It can't be a traditional agriculture. Many of them can have market linked through e-commerce. It becomes necessary. If MSM is today, many of them are surviving well after all the breakup, etc., they get into e-commerce. Your products have to be out. Whether it goes to Amazon or whether it goes to somebody, doesn't matter. Your thing can reach Kanyakumari. It can reach Andaman. It can reach Bangkok. So those type of things are possible, and that itself will the local retail, it is not against. See, the trouble in India is we put everything versus. We say environmental versus growth. We say retail versus this thing. Kirana store also will be there. Even in USA, there are many Kirana stores, the 7-Up, etc., they are still there. They will find a new balance. So it is in this context, then I looked at. So, and again, this will require a whole set of new skills. Whole set of new skills. That is what people like you have to be done. It doesn't, it is not another PhD, it is not another BA. Whatever you know, it will be a very narrow sector. You ask how many number of people, Professor Prohit and the party, they have trained here. Similarly in other Sikkim, they are all very this thing, but you have to be trained in that. Now we have got much more easier with computer, animation and all that. Their knowledge could have been brought in. I am coming to that later. It is in this context, I am happy to see the ICT penetration. ICT means information and communication technologies penetration in Uttarakhand, quite good. 0.81 million wired lines, 167 point wireless subscribers, internet is about 52.130. How good they are in the far flung, I could not do a detailed work, but it can be done. I am not worried. It is important to increase the internet penetration in the smartphones. Smartphones should be made available. There's one thing which for poor people or women, students, etc., government can give in some subsidized form. It need not be from the government money. The companies themselves will do when you guarantee a certain number of purchases. Availability of smartphones in the hands of families in Uttarakhand, one family at least one, in the rural and less connected areas is crucial. It can be the target also for every student. It is possible now. And another thing, very good thing has happened about a month or two ago, ISRO had launched a satellite. It's some 10, 15 years of lifetime. They say that it is specifically focused for internet connections in the hilly areas and all that, because satellites can see it. It is no tower problem is there. It is the biggest tower, 36,000 kilometer high, synchronizing with the earth. So this can be, don't think when you satellite, don't look at this EduSat on this antenna, this old 1995. These things are very new ones. Companies can come and do. It need not be taken up by Uttarakhand government, everything. You have to enable it. In fact, they can take a great leap. This one, I think, can be done within 2 to 3 years. So Uttarakhand, with this one, you should aim at a digital Uttarakhand within 3 to 4 years. Digital Uttarakhand is possible, because many things can be reached. Of course, there is a problem of the transportation there. That is to be told locally, in that there are some other things available. It is not like going to the moon. When you say satellite, don't think that it is landing in moon. These are all very simple. Ye mobile mein aa jayega. Aapka antenna ka zarurat nahi hai. There will be some other things which they will do. So let 3 year be the target, 2022. Now it is that access markets, the linkages, the e-commerce, etc., will be possible. Many good businesses will go around it, helping rural persons, farmers, women, everybody. Each of them can be this, and these businesses will employ many youth. Not all need to be You need not, you'll be doing everything on the bulb and everything. They will do one supply chain. They will know how to file a, somebody will do filing of a GST. He was telling about how the compliances have become much easier. So somebody can help. That will be a big business. Once, little box in their home itself. Many men, boys and girls can do it. And they need not all be very greatly educated. Even 10, 12 is enough. Because there are packages available. Of course, things like payment by government also becomes easy. So far, we have touched two items. Value-added agriculture, different from what it is now. Aiming at a world market. And we should also be, it should try to be a hub of some special agricultural product. That is where a brand, Uttarakhand, this is what it is. Today, the small country, Netherlands, all tulips of the world will come there. How they do? So you can aim at that, it is not very difficult. Because you have got already, this part of the country is so beautiful in terms of name. Name is known, everybody known. There are so many things that are brand. You have to develop the brand. So digital Uttarakhand is another thing which I said. So if you do this, I see a possibility when I studied that there are some, the hilly tracks, about 1,000-odd villages have been left out. So they are called ghost villages. Actually, if government works it very carefully, those places where fellows have left and gone, because they are, those things can become a place where some of these experiments can be done and modeled. New things can be done. And pay them rent. Don't take it away, pay them rent for which what you do. So some thinking will be necessary. I'm glad that Dr. Das is there. He will know the administrative nuances for it, because it's not enough to know only science, technology, businesses, etc. How to do these things also equally important. Now coming to industries. Now I'm going to the other sector. Value addition in a large scale. I found it as a base of good modern industry. I was really surprised. About 10 days ago, I was in an international machine tool exhibition in Bangalore. IMTEX, they saw the 50th year. Now, fellows are, up to last year, it was not becoming so big. They have a great place, but there are so many people come to India. The make in India and other things have become big. Then, whenever I go, I'll say, kidhar hota hai, kidhar use karte hai. So I asked a fairly good company, which is doing 3D and that type of thing, very sophisticated machines. Where all you supply? Then he had a map, in India map. I was really surprised. Then 5-6 places of Uttarakhand was there. You supply there? Because I didn't think that. Yes, sir. We are doing there. We good. This one's on it. I couldn't find out. I didn't have time to find out which industry and other things they were. So in other words, it is already there. Many of you don't know. Even I didn't know. So it is to get more of this will be, again, many people were genuinely concerned about environment. I have been concerned about environment from 74 onwards, because in space, we were the first fellows, we showed the blue earth. We means not Indians, space technology. We are very deeply concerned, we look at it. But immediately industry means they think in terms of chimney. Now there is no chimneys now. But there are still big machines will be there. So these are the things, electronics and optic assembly. I have given some example. 3D manufacturing. 3D manufacturing, I was surprised that Calcutta airport, you go and see it. You'll see some, your big Durga. This big play. Then I was wondering how to do metal. I knew metal, ceramics. How do you put such a big one? I tracked it and then they found out they do it from ordinary waste paper. He has got a small machine. The fellows are good technologies. They do that much part and then they can do some stitching on that. Big one. So you think of it for artisanal products from here. 3D means what takes 2 years in an ordinary this thing, this will do in 2 months, 3 months, because it is all fed, computer fed, and then the machine does it. Machine you don't have to make, they are all imported. Some are going to be manufactured in India. So there are variety of possibilities. It can work with metals, it can work with so many things. Then bioprocessing. This is whole chemical engineering is transforming. There are a lot of things referred to beyond that. In addition to 2020, there is another book by Dr. Kalam. This is just one, which he finished just before he sat this thing. going, passing away, October, this is beyond 2020. We have listed many items of which it can be taken. Again, the bioprocessing means getting those type of plants, trees, etc. Again, the people who know plants, who know trees, will be very essential. Along with the chemical engineering one, there are many products. There are some 2-3 very good reports from TIFAC which we have referred. What can be done? There are also go beyond. It is not all short term. Some are short term, some are long term. Advanced health project, food processing with the due care for effluence. Because food processing, you should not do the traditional way. There are many things available. My suggestion that Uttarakhand need not be worried about MSMEs in localizing them. I find there localizing. MSMEs are very important, crucial. I always compare it like this. See the beautiful peaks. Big companies are like the peaks. But you can't have the peaks without the bottom. But if you don't have a peak, the bottom, nobody sees it. A dump here. So both are actually complementary. So that is what is to be seen. And the global connection of the products which are necessary through the e-commerce. So a number of small items will come, some will go away, some will come, some new one will come, all that. 3D manufacturing, I already told you. This can be done. The secondary sector growth then will become very fast and it can employ a lot of people, not just generally, because everybody thinks SME means most of the young people don't want to go. Are grease hai, itna hamara haath ganda ho jayega. I used to ask in 96 around schools, school boys and girls, nobody wants to go to agriculture. Arey Baba, agriculture doesn't mean only ploughing there. You have biotechnology, you have got tissue culture, you have got so many things. You can equally have. Yeah, they said that we want air conditioned place. Arey Baba, air conditioned mein kar sakta hai. So there are so many available. You look at it. Then this is done. I come to a great thing of Uttaranchal. Tourism. From religion to spirituality to serenity to adventure to scientific explorer, you can add anything, including even seeing how disasters are. Because Indonesians show their volcanic problem in Bali, that part itself people go and see. But I also gone and seen. So, however, the digital for this, it can't ramp up unless you have digital Uttarakhand. Then only people will come, because today's everybody, business person, ordinary fellow, student, everybody wants to have connected. Mom, I am here. Want to show one picture. If they can do it, then they are happy. So the mom also wants to phone up, hey, what is happening there? So this is what is the reality. Also, do not live with the physical visits alone. This is one item I am giving you, something special. Don't live only with the physical visits. Regular one, Badrinath, udhar to jaake karna padega. But there are places which have been identified, which I will tell you, hybridize them with virtual reality. You know, virtual reality is, you feel the same thing, it is all done. It is a modern one possible, it doesn't require too much money these days. Many companies will do it, provided you enabled. Do it, you can feel, oh, you go and touch that pillar, you go and touch that he. Everything can be done, but you do the thing. So keep in the traditional places, when they go, are bhai, ye bhi dekho. Of course, all by payment only. Nothing, anything which is done by free will not survive. Unless somebody keeps on giving money, initially can be some item. Sitting in those beautiful environments, look also the virtuality show. Then people will say, which are the new places you have to market this way? This identified not by me. This is identified by analyst and I think government also. Jogeshwar, Baijnath, Saath. My pronunciation may be wrong because I have taken it from English. Thal, Bheem Thal, Patal, Bhuvaneshwar, Chakori, Someshwar, Pithorgarh, Chakrata, Roopkund, Hanuval, Ansan, Baraj, Harshil, Danulti, then Daryana, Daryana Meadows. Like that, there are many. One can get it and then market them. Because once these fellows see in the virtual world, then they are coming. And then they have seen it here. Don't put it generally in the website. Website, you put only a glimpse. Because people should not, if you want to market, you should not show everything. You should only a small item. So that you have to attract them to buy it. That is why even in Google Books and all, some 10 pages they will show. Rest of it you have to pay. So you have to think in those terms, but let them come here. With some CSR and government support, many startup entrepreneurs can start it. Then later big fellows will come. It will be a big business called this business with the name which I say, I have not made it. Creative industries. They are called creative industries. Film, this one, that one, etc. And they got animation. You know, you see in the films, your heroes and heroines are all jumping around so many places with so much of flower, this, etc. And then these heroes are having some six-pack and other thing. I can be made to show six-pack. Do you know that? I can show six-pack. They will show me the six-pack. So what happens is, nowadays, most of what you see is only quasi-real. These things are done on it, and then they pick. They show a patch of this one, this whole university campus can be blooming with whatever, chrysanthemum or whatever you can have. You put photo lelo, usko ye fill up kar do. And that doing it is a great art and science. This is not computer science alone. A young man who started off with software, he is now in this business, he does it even for Hollywood. He requires a lot of young people, because people come, do it very well, then they themselves go directly to get a job, do something. So you need a supply of people. So think of it, these things are very great. Now let the usual tourism be there, nucleate these items around it in the next years. By 2040, you will become a booming business within this one. Then tourism also has a tourism at the other side. It is there with not only with there is prosperity also. The amount of waste you young fellows will generate is many more than what your grandpa did. More money in hand, richer the nation, richer the garbage. Because I worked with garbage processing in 1989 onwards for this one, Bombay and all that thing. More tourists, they will do whatever you say. Do okay, plastic mat rakho, paper lagaye dega. Ye mat karo, the cotton this one thaili ko phekega. So there are many things you can't be without that. So not only that, the more the people that I have told already. So one important thing you should start off now itself is that waste water recycling and garbage recycling. This can be done in 3 years with the known technologies. Then later, as we were talking about Dr. Nachiket Das, on a longer term, it has to get into zero waste generation. So you kill the source itself. There are many things possible. People are doing research. But these other items, you have to do it in a form. Make it a rule that wastewater recycling, wherever people are there, 10,000 people, whether it is a slum, whether it is an apartment, whether it is a large town, etc., they have to recycle their water. Don't throw it away. Our Ganga Mata has become dirty, not for anything else. We all leave sewage there. While coming here, I find between that secretariat and that house, that river is gone. It is so everywhere. It is so in Bangalore. Posh Indiranagar colony, you will have this. Because we think we are the holiest people. Are recycle kaisa karega? Israel does 85% to 90%. Even agricultural water has to be recycled. So this is one thing. The entire now comes to your education system. Our education system, read, write, arithmetic, good, they've got a good literacy rate. That's no good anymore. My father passed matriculation, somehow he became a clerk long, long ago. So I somehow was there. My grandfather was a great Vedic scholar. It's called Ganapati. It's a very special title for... He didn't put his sons on this because he knew Nayoga matriculation diya. If I had been only matriculation, imagine what would have been. I did an MSc. See, now, you not only require that type of this one, you need skills. Post 11, 12, you need skills. Even if you are 8, you need skills. The new skills which will be keeping on changing. And this, how to integrate it. I hope that the Doon University takes some new initiative. Vice Chancellor was telling me that MSME things are there, and that you can integrate. I think there are a number of things which can be done. With the physical as well as the cyber technology. It has to be a blend. Physical and then the cyber technologies can augment it. It is called blended education. And I have some more, but I will not be going on telling all that. But I got two more important items. You have got a problem. Disaster. You can't do anything to it. certain amount can be done, because the landslide, etc., geotextiles can be done, but we were promoting it from all over India, promoting it. Geotextiles, we got it done, but people don't do, because in India, these are all small problems. We like a crisis to develop, and then people, heroes come, they do something, and then they disappear. Afterwards, everybody forgets it. So this something can be done. I am not adding that as a main item. But Uttarakhand, having to live with it, has got a special this one. You know how to do, how to live with disaster management. In addition to the National Disaster Management Agency statement, I think it can be created as a business. Some portions of it, anywhere in the India, chalo phone karo, at least some portions. It can be like a regular service which can be given. Services sector includes that also. Other one is, this I will call it Uttarakhand DM Services, big company. Second is the security systems. Very sad thing what happened yesterday. It happens because these things is going to live with it. One thing I can tell you, young people, as technology is improved, the other side of it also comes. Terrorism will be there, some extremism, you know, deal with it. That requires not necessarily, you got some of the best men in the army, defense services. I'm not telling only the shooting part, cyber security. And then even many of these could have been modeled. I'm not criticizing anybody, but the whole intelligence services, if they collect data and then model it, many of them can be preempted. So then, do you know who bombed Afghanistan and those other areas which are there? Many of them are young women sitting there in Washington, D.C. Oh, karo ye karke, duk, hit the target. So there is so many things. Don't think it is only for the men. We bada mooch karke udhar, that was once upon a time. Security is there everywhere. Bank, which transaction, they say forensic audit, ye kya hai? These are all done by big data analysis. This can be done again. Many of the BCom students here can get in it. But you don't have to be a BCom also. You can learn the packages. So I will just mention about it, then because this is also the last one, last major item, women empowerment. For me, it is a very special topic because my young age, 10 years onwards, my 10 years onwards, a great national poet. I think nobody had addressed it before like him in 1905 to 1910. He has got a, what is the new Indian woman? He was inspired by Sister Nivedita. That is Subramanya Bharati. Oh God, what? If I tell, you are not understanding Hindi itself. So if I tell the Tamil, then what can I do? It's a very beautiful poem as to how a modern woman will be. Nimurunda nannade nerhunda parvayum, he will say. Nilathil arkum enjaad nermayum. See the force he gives it. Nimurunda nannade. Woman in those days has to be like this. Nimurunda nannade. She will look at the eyes. He has told it in 1910. Okay? That's the type of person. Yes, I am for all women empowerment, but I have seen so many programs in the government of India. They will only think of carpet weaving, basket making. Yes, that is also a part of women. But if anything which is given doesn't give minimum of 200 rupees for a 8 hours work for her, she might do it at home. I reject it. That is exploitation by unproductivity, because they can't do more. You have to have things from them onwards to women. Let them be technicians, let them be nurses, let them be pilots, to fighter pilots, to police, to scientists, to astronomers, to sports, to boxing. And all these are a spectrum. Many of you here are a different type of woman. You can even teach your moms to do this. Even your grandmas can do some of the things by e-commerce. Arey baba, jada takleef nahi hai, ye booking karo, ye sab. It can be done. So I look at it that way, along with doing those women will be for the high-end agriculture. Bottom ones who are there. The artisanal ones can be done. So that is the way I would like to look at it. Don't look at women as a defensive, sitting at their baithke, ghar pe baithenge, thoda ye kuch kamai milenge. Because why I am telling this is health. Yes, they say education and health. Who will take care of health? Suppose I fall ill as a bread earner, everybody will take care of me. That is why men were taken care of. Women was not considered. If women is also equally earned like men. Doesn't have to go to office. Those days are gone now. There is no longer going to be 95. It will be a few places. But most of the other things are going to be, you can do anywhere, flexi times and all that thing. So they can do so well that money which they earn will give the respect for them. If a woman is not empowered with the modern skills to earn modern money, to live, they will be gone. So that is my plea. So that will help women also in many ways. The above certain elements of sustainable urbanization, they contain sustainable urbanization per se, not bad. Urbanization per se is not bad. People go to urban areas because they get better income. So when we can diversify the better income avenues, people will be there, it will take care of themselves. As far as smart towns, I have a view based on considerable experience or research. Isolating smart towns, etc., uska zamana gaya. Things are going so fast, you can reach satellites with that everywhere, you can do smartphones. So I see by 2030, the entire Uttarakhand will be a smart state. If we can start off the digital one, what I had told before. I am deeply aware of the issues of environment, etc. I have not specifically mentioned about it. I am much more. In fact, one of the books which he mentioned that just come out, I always worry about how to deal with nature, science, and this thing. See, you should remember, when India got independence, the population now is 5 times. World, it is like that. Don't think solutions of 10,000 years ago or 1,000 years ago will work. You have to do it in a modern one. And then a lot of science inputs have to come. That is why, where it is in the plant, soil biology will become very important. You can't reclaim it just like that. There are the people who will know, those who deal with plants, etc. Then the tourists who go to different parts of this one will enjoy through the smart these things. And environment will be, all rich developed countries have taken care of their environment. Germany was bad, now it is so good. Rhine was terrible. Where Ganga will take place only when we take all this. Then whoever comes to Uttarakhand, they will be able to talk to anybody. That is a smart one. By 2040, I would suggest that Uttarakhand, now the last one, economic data which I want to give you as a target. It is possible. India's, today Uttarakhand's contribution to India as a whole, GDP, is 1.3%. When it started as a state, it was 0.8%. So it's good. Now I suggest a target by 2040, you have to become 2.5% to 8%. Just like Switzerland in Europe, it creates much more. So you put that as a target. It's not a difficult target. In fact, you should be slightly more ambitious. With this target, with some glimpses as to how to put this, you can achieve a lot. Then I don't want to take too much time, but I suggest this cannot be done. Your conferences you are having is good. You have to continue more conferences. But conferences often have a tendency to end up as reports and other thing. Everybody, there, dusra conference kab hoga? I would suggest that you have a task force led by Das Saab and a few others, Vice Chancellor, and then a few others. Some can be people like Professor Prohit can be an advisor, telling them whether where you're going wrong, right, etc. So a few more people. The task force should not be 120. Task force is not more than 12. You have subgroups. And I suggest that you have a implementable road plan by August 15, 2019. 6 months is good enough time. In our time, we took 2 years because we didn't have internet and all. You know, you can talk to people, you can do even face to face, you can visit fast. 2019, and then launch that mission, set of missions, not one mega mission of 2040 means nothing will come. That will be a political speech. That has to be done by chief ministers, prime ministers, chief secretaries and all have to do. Even I have written papers for them to give those talks. But what to actually do will be small projects which will give results in 2-3 years, etc., etc. And launch it by 9th November 2019. Any of you know what is the significance of the 9th November? The state was formed. Good. So keep that as a target. If you put that November, then you are ready for 2020 to 2040. There'll be 3 year, 4 year, 5 year, those type of things have to come. Now lastly, I want to end with a quote. I got it from a book, The Origin of Wealth, Evolution, Complexity, and Radical Remaking of Economics by Eric Beinhoker. I suggest you all read that book. It's a fantastic book. I quote it because you are in a journey. You are all looking, what is it? The young people, even without Vision 2040, you will all be wanting to discover the new paths, where you will go, etc. So 2040 exercise is a great discovery also on the other side. So for that, there is a very beautiful quote. This I will read slow. If I want necessary, I will repeat it. With that, I end. The real voyage of discovery consists not in new landscapes. Real voyage of discovery consists not in seeking new landscapes, but in having new eyes. God bless. Thank you.